271,000 ADP private payroll company big? That tries to estimate what the government will report on Friday for the private payrolls estimates 271,000. That is against a forecast of 178,000. I need my glasses
well,
for that
you
part.
This number. That's why you were so positive
That's
about
the
economy earlier.
I wanted to get off set. I didn't know if I had enough money to talk, Joe. Tell me what the ante is to talk on this
well,
show.
Well, you can relay okay. information that you
right.
get.
Without opinion, right? Yeah, November exactly. payrolls revised down 22,157. So we get something of a snapback here. We'll get into the details in a minute. Goods, 47,000. Services strong at 224,000. The non-farm payroll estimate for Friday is 176,000. So we'll see if people think like there's some upside surprise here. Let's go into the details. Look at it by business size. Small business, 89,000. That's a healthy number. 129 for medium size and large a little bit on the short side there, 54,000. And then when I look at the by sector, you see the construction there. So maybe something of a weather snapback. We were still looking for some of that. And I'll talk to Mark Zandi in a second. December's not a great... Oh, he's not there.
I don't think so.
No. I didn't know that. Anyway, well...
They just said it in our ear.
Who am I? Swiss cheese up here? No. Okay, anyway. Now, the point is that December's not a great month for ADP. They run about a 42,000 plus or minus error with the BLS.
Just in terms of linking up.
And December on the first reported go-round is not their best month. So there are times of change in the economy like November to December, or actually it's October to November, December. We add all these additional seasonal workers. They'll come off in January. The summertime is also not a great month for them as well. So those are two places.
So maybe a big beat here doesn't necessarily relate into a big beat on Friday, at least historically speaking.
But you have to wonder, one thing ADP is very good at, if not the exact number, directionally relative to the consensus. When they're up there, payrolls tend to be on the high side. When they're down there, payrolls tend to be on the low
side.
We're
in a weird place right now.
What do we want?
Exactly.
I don't know. I thought this would be a lousy number for the market.
No,
what did futures do?
But seriously, what do we want? If it's a hot number, then we're back to worrying about
Joe,
the Fed. But we're all worried about global growth now.
We are.
I was looking at the bond market.
What did it do?
The 2-year yield bumped up slightly, a slight flattening action, which would be like, you know, a very muted version of what you would expect if it was okay. The Fed is back.
I want
the game.
More.
But if the market is really saying the Fed, perhaps, as many are saying, should go slower, it's because of tightening financial conditions largely.
Right.
So I think that they don't necessarily think employment is that
good. Then let's keep adding a lot.
That's a good point.
I think I stay to first principles all the time. I always want more growth. I always want more jobs.
Right.
That is done pretty well. Let the artificial stuff, the market level relative to those things, and the Fed's level relative to those things adjust, which can be adjusted. You cannot control ultimately, at least on a short-term basis, the number of jobs created or the amount of growth. Let that be good. Let's fix the other stuff as well. The market, they can reconcile if they made a mistake as well, and the Fed can too. The market could end up here, and I believe this will be the case, being too pessimistic about this.
Being too pessimistic about the economy?
About the outlook. I think it's overly pessimistic. I really hope I'm right about this. I don't want to be wrong about it.
Yeah.
The market has gone a long way. People with a lot of money think I'm wrong.